Now let's implement the absolute positioning section. Why we are implementing that? Let me show you. Let me create a number of nodes. Let me change the color. Okay. Now suppose I try to resize this. See, the other node's position is getting changed according to this one's position. Suppose I close this one. See, all the other items after that one is getting relocated. So I don't want that to happen. When I close this one, this and this should remain in its original position itself. So that is why we are going to implement absolute positioning. So how we can implement that? After appending, we can get the top and left position of this button and make some modifications and set that as the top and left positions of the sticky notes. Okay. So here after this appending, let me create where left equals dollar this dot position dot left. This is the left value of the button because we are clicking the BTN new button. Similarly, let me get where top equals dollar this dot position dot top. So this will give us the left and top values of the button. So what we need to do next? So if this is the left and top, for this one, that is for the first sticky note, we can have the same left value as that of the button. And the top value can be same for all the sticky notes. And to get the top value, we need to add some value to this top. That is the button's top value. So how we can do that? For the left, for the very first one, let it be the same. And for the top, let me add a value of 50. Why? Because the height of the button is 40px, right? Here we have set the height to be 40. So I'm adding 10 and set plus 50 so that the sticky notes position will be from here 50. Okay, so there'll be enough gap. And for the first sticky notes, let this be the same value. So we need to loop through the sticky notes now. So how we can do that? Let me specify dollar dot sticky. Let me loop through this dot each and here function. And within this, let me write dollar this dot CSS and putting curly brace and left to be left plus px. Because here we are getting numbers. Actually, we need to set left and top as px values. So left as this and top as top plus px. So this will be the left and top values. And before setting the left of the next sticky note, I need to increment it. So let me specify left plus equals. Let me see the width of the item. This is width is 200px. And we have also set a margin of 10 and padding of 5. 200 plus 20 will be required by margin on both the sides. Then 5px is the padding. So 10 again. So let me add 230 for the next item, or let it be 235px. Okay. So left plus equals 230. Now I need to specify the position as well. So position to be absolute. So here we have set left, top and also position. So for the sticky, here we have specified float to be left. That is not required. So let me remove that. Let me save. Let me refresh. Let me click new note, new note. Okay. And for the last one, let me change the color for the items. Let me close this. See, the other items are not getting relocated. Again, if I move this, it is not getting relocated, right? It is moving without relocating the other items. Suppose I move this towards this side and click this. It is coming on the top. Let me enter the values, pay errands fee, get grocery bill, and I can resize the items. I can remove this one as well. Remove new note, change the color. Like this, we are able to do a number of things using our online sticky notes application, like creating new notes, entering the text, moving the items, then again bringing any other clicked item to the top, remove notes, resize them, Like this, we are able to do a number of things using our online sticky notes application. So this is actually a very big project, the complete online sticky notes application. You can add more functionalities if you want. So we have developed the online sticky notes application from scratch using jQuery UI's draggable and resizable interactions.